2 for the Big Ten, yo.
Lion, nobody else. Jogging with the herb at the field for the healing of the nation. Fruit and vegetable for
welcome everybody. So nice to see the smiling faces. Variation,
sustenance for our generation. It's there in abundance. Minerals and holy
parts. A new chance. Anti-inflammatory and anti-oxidant. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Throw some love on the chat, y'all. Throw some love. Good morning.
Health is wealth. Vital is vital. You can rely on nobody else. Health is wealth.
Health is wealth. You hear it. You hear it.
Try and take care of yourself. Health is wealth. Vital is vital.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning, team.
Vegan, we're vegan.
Around the world.
Plant BS, we say. Long time Rastafari. Stay out there, so he day. Vital, we vital. Not going away. And we root and we fruit and we vegetable all the way. Cause health is wealth. Vital is vital.
That's right.
You gotta think
someone on
yourself.
The chat found out who the artist is. Who's the artist here?
You can't rely on nobody else.
Take your guess, but wealth. Someone already put it on there.
Vital. Try and take care of yourself. Health is wealth.
Amy Byer, so good to see you.
Don't you realize your body is a temple? Certain vitamins, they are essential.
All right, let's stop the share real quick. Hey, 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 good morning, family. Welcome, everybody, for day 2. We really hope yesterday was incredible and filled your cup from a spiritual level, but also on a practical level. So it was an incredible first day yesterday. So we're going to go back to back right now. It's going to be an incredible day with Leaving to Learn. So we got a dope pick me up for you guys. I'm going to give it to them. But before we do that, is Rose here? Rose? Holly, is Rose here?
Not yet. She's coming.
Oh, she's not. All right. All right. So we're going to hold tight. Listen, I'm going to hand it off. I'm not going to do a proper introduction, but I'm just going to give it to my sister, Asari, who's been leading this really dope initiative that really captures the song Health is Wealth. Asari, take the mic, sis. Let them know what you're here for.
Awesome. Thank you. Hi, everyone. I'm Isari. I help manage our Big Picture Living initiative. And today we have our Skunk Works high school students here who will be leading our pick-me-up. So I will be dropping a PowerPoint that we'd love everyone to participate in this activity, and it'll be led by Alicia. So Alicia, feel free to take the mic.
Isari, could you screen share the card?
Yes, I'll also do a screen share.
Yeah, okay, so hi everyone. My name's Alicia. I'm from Next School in Mumbai. And I am part of the Skunk Works team. The Skunk Works team is a group of high school students from across the world who are trying to work for the BP Living Initiative. So the BP Living Initiative is a collaboration with ACLM, American College of Lifestyle Medicine, to help promote the 6 measures or the 6 pillars of healthy living, which is move, sleeping right, recharge, and we have chill, which is stress resilience, caution, staying away from harmful substances, social, having good relationships with your family, friends, etc., and nourish, which is eating right. So through these measures, we want to take a more preventive approach to health and healthy living as a whole. And so today's pick me up is, this is a change I can make in me to help us all get a powerful V. Especially looking at this year's theme for the Big Bang, this is something that you want, this is a change, this is something that you want to bring in your life with regards to these measures that will help you in, you know, better your health or help you in your community change something. And so, for example, it could be a change that I want to make in me is that I want to, I take a lot of stress and I panic a lot. I get very anxious about things. So one change that I want to make in myself is to be able to reduce that, is to be able to take more time to relax. And that is my answer for this. So we do encourage you to share, use the, it's been shared in the chat, the change in me, pick me up. We do encourage you to, you know, download it, change, add in your own words and post it on social media. We're available on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So.
Awesome. Thank you, Alicia. So we'll give it a couple minutes so everyone has time to write. This is a PowerPoint that's edible. You can edit it. So just type in your answer here. And then as Alicia mentioned, if you could take a photo and tag us on social media, we would love to see your answers and repost how we can all create a better community. I just reshared the pick me up in case some people aren't able to access it. I'll also share the link to our website. So let me pull that up. Okay, awesome. So my colleague, Andrea, who also helps us run the Big Picture Living Initiative, just dropped in the link. So in case you weren't able to access the PowerPoint, please click that link and it'll take you to our website's homepage where we have this, this template. So if you still want to keep working on that, please do take your time. Meanwhile, we are going to start sharing just some personal stories from our Skunkworks on their journey of well-being and self-growth. So we have today Maria, Alicia, and Tirza, and each one is going to take just a couple of minutes to kind of share their experience thus far with the initiative. So Maria, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, as Asari said, I'm Maria. I'm from Auto System Academy, and I'm also part of the Skunkworks. A few things I've done during this initiative is I led a lot of conversations and webinars, which are also on the website if you want to check them out under the student resources. I led webinars and many conversations on this topic at my school. And I also put out a survey that I plan on doing annually to check up on my school's wellness in general, because I feel like it's something very important we should take care of and address issues that we find during the year. Last survey, I had some noticings that our school is really struggling on mental health, and I'm trying to fix that by setting up a club where we can support them and guide them more towards where we think they need help in, you know, the middle way, because not a lot of people feel comfortable reaching out to adults and feel like if they have like the option to reach out to people their age, that they'll do it. But yeah, that's what I've been doing during this initiative. I'll pass it to Alicia.
Hello everyone. Me and some of my peers from my school got introduced to the BP Living Project through ZOT, which is a sort of gathering for BP Living, big picture learning students. And it's been quite a while since we've been involved and we've gotten a lot of work done. So one of our main projects has been the podcast. It's called It Happened to Me, and it's a series of relatable but and realistic realistic talks, etc., about the six measures and what we feel in it, and what it's like really from the heart, and you know, something that we want to put out there that's not in any way exaggerated or romanticized. We want it to be as real as possible. So that's the idea behind the It Happened to Me podcast, which is one of our main projects. Additionally, we've also started, so there at our school every week there we have one session where the whole, most of the school meets. Most of like the high school plus middle school students meet, and one grade, you know, presents or performs something. So our grade took it up on ourselves to sort of divide the students into breakout rooms and give them knowledge about each of the measures. So for example, there was a room for move where they were, you know, the students were doing different exercises with my peers, and there was a room for nourish where recipes were being shared, as well as people were talking about plant-based diets and what's, you know, what's good, what's not good, what's considered healthy versus what really, you know, what really you should be including in your diet, and having discussions on that. And then in another room, we were talking about recharge and how it's really difficult, especially for people close to our age group, because exams and schoolwork become really important and integrate with our life, but at the same time we don't want to compromise in social life. So what it does take a hit is our health and our sleep. So there was conversations about that, and overall we were able to sort of get a lot of our juniors, get a lot of the students at our school involved with the Big Picture Living Project. Additionally, we also started doing something called advisory talks, where we have discussions or games focused in our advisories, and we talk about things that aren't usually spoken about, especially around the measure caution, which is one of the most important measures, I think, because it's a really huge taboo in our country, at least. It's nobody really talks about it. It's considered, but a lot of students are involved in it. And, you know, teachers know that students are involved in it, and there's no sort of efforts from anyone to stop it, because it's considered such a taboo and nobody just wants to talk about it. So we had conversations about that, conversations about consequences, and conversations about why and when do we actually get involved in these things, and how we can avoid it, at least when we are underage. So these were some of the projects that we've been working with. And for next year, we have a few things planned. So I'm excited to see how that plays out. I guess I'll hand it over to Tiersa now.
Hello, I'm very nervous, so forgive me. So ever since I joined BP Living, it's improved my life more like socially, because I'm very socially awkward and I don't meet a lot of new people. And ever since I joined, thank you for this is awesome hat. Anyway, yeah, I've grown a lot socially, and I just felt so happy joining them because I got new friends, and it's like you get a feeling that you have a lot of, it helps you socially and mentally, so you don't think that you're alone, and it doesn't lead you to a dark path where you think that you don't have anybody in your life. So I'm glad to have joined. And I led a Galaxy Jar activity in one of our BP Living challenges. So if you sorry could show the video, this taught me leadership skills. So I wouldn't mind doing it again. And I had a lot of fun doing it.
Hello people, I am the Galaxy Master, and I'll be teaching you how to make a galaxy jar. First, you need to fill up your jar with water. It has to be 1/3 of the jar. Next, you want to add one of your paints that you want to start with. I have gold and red because they are my favorites. Something you need to know about me. We'll start with gold first, and what we're going to do is add a few drops in there, and a lot of... We're going to start mixing it.
Okay.
So, you need a stick, and just...
Mine came out, I mixed purple and blue, so, I mean red and blue, so it's making purple.
Cool. Okay, so when we're done mixing, you want to grab your cotton balls, and what the goal is you need to take them apart, like stretch them out, so they look a little bit like clouds.
Okay.
So, yeah. When you're done, you put it in your galaxy jar, all of your cotton balls, and with the stick, you're going to want to start pushing them down.
Do we add glitter at this point too? If we want to put like, okay, cool. So I have these like Target glitter stars. I'm just going to throw them in there. This is my first galaxy jar. I've actually never made one of these before.
I didn't even know what a galaxy jar was till like 5 minutes before this meeting.
My thing looks like boba right now.
Yeah. Mine's like this. That looks cool. Silver, I like that.
So when you're done with the glitter and the cotton balls,
yeah,
you're going to add more water to fill the rest of the 1/3, and then you add your second color.
Ooh.
So I'll be right back.
I know I ran to 99 to get paint because I realized I didn't have any, and I just picked up like all this random stuff along the way because yeah, I was like, maybe I could throw these in there.
Ooh. Is that ribbon? Okay.
Nice. Yeah, you could literally throw anything in here, like little toys, beads, buttons.
I don't know what you call these, but I used it to just put it outside.
So, a pipe cleaner?
Pipe cleaners, yes.
I think I got mine done. I have a nice little gray streak here. So I have like blue, pink, and then like this gray cloud.
It's a one.
Ooh.
Nice. Yay. Okay. We're going to take a picture together.
Thank you all. You have impressed the Galaxy Master today. You've all done very well, especially Alicia. I like yours the best.
We are happy to serve you, Captain.
Where can people go for more information, Tirza?
People can go to bpliving.org for more information.
Awesome. Great job.
Yay. Thank you so much, Tirza, for leading us through that awesome activity. This was a way that we were practicing our chill measure. And as you can see, the Big Picture Living Initiative gave us the opportunity to still meet and connect, even if it was virtual. Since, you know, due to COVID, we couldn't meet in person. So this was a way where students could get involved, exploring their interests, exploring overall health and well-being, and yeah, get to connect and get to know other Big Picture Learning schools. So if you are interested, I will be dropping my email in the chat. And also, if you could follow us on social media, that's another way where we share news, ways that students could get involved, such as our anthology where students are writing poems. And yeah, to close us off, or before closing us off, I did want to share our link for Monday, which I totally forgot to share. So if you were able to join us for our breakthrough session, please let us know what you thought of the session, what you liked, what you'd love to learn more about. So I dropped the link in the chat. And then we'd love to leave you with two questions of reflection. So we have Maria and Alicia.
Okay, my question of reflection is, if your change could help change the world, would you do it?
And playing off on that, my question to all of you is, what can you do to start creating this change today?
Awesome. Thank you. So yeah, if you could let us know your answer, share it with us on social media. We would love to hear your thoughts. And yeah, just wanted to show everyone, this is our Instagram page where we've had one of our quite a few of our challenges. And this was a way that we were able to encourage students to continue to stay active, making healthy choices, move, socialize in healthy ways. And we'd love to invite your schools and advisories to also join us in this new initiative. As we mentioned yesterday during our breakthrough session, we also have tons of resources on our website and these videos. If you'd also like to learn more about our Big Picture Living webinars led by our Odyssey STEM Academy students, please do visit our website. And yeah, I think that, do we have any questions? Or Sun, did we want to do a grounding or closing off before we take off to the rest of our sessions?
Yeah, we're going to do that, but we're going to give the mic right now to the good brother, Chris Jackson, who's going to check in.
All right, folks, can you hear me? Thumbs up. Thank you. I find myself often in the position of comms guy, following Big Picture students from across the country. And I will tell you, it is always lose-lose. You know, our Big Picture students inspire so much, and I have to follow and give logistic announcements. I just want to give it up for the Skunk Works team. Thank you so much for our morning inspiration. I think a lot of folks might have noticed Big Picture staff and more are sporting these Big Bang backgrounds. If you're wondering where you might get those, I've asked Anna to drop a link into the chat to a Google Drive where you can download the Zoom backgrounds if you'd like them. No pressure. Reiterating some of the things I had said yesterday, the hashtag we're using for this conference is the Bang 2021. And I also want to point out that on Instagram and also Twitter, our avatar is at Big Pick Learning. And I'm pointing out Instagram today because for the last two mornings, Sun and Carla and I have jumped on IG Live at 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific, just having fun, just giving a lowdown on the day. We'd love to see more folks join that. Shout out to Carla, did Instagram Live this morning from a stand-up board. in a river. So you can do these things from anywhere. If you're on Facebook, we're at Big Picture Learning. Folks, a lot of the information for the conference is at bplevents.org. All of the links you need for sessions coming up are on the Zoom links drop-down menu. And I'm going to tell you now, because you got here somehow, that the password you need to access those links is thebang2021. No hashtag for that, thebang2021. If you still find difficulty getting into stuff, events@bigpicturelearning.org is your place to go. I know some folks have not received their recipe kit. I have mine. Oh, here it is over my messy desk. So if you haven't got it and you want it for Thursday night session, take a screenshot right now, okay? But also I think, sorry, do you want to drop it in the chat as well? Appreciate it, okay? So if you know how to screenshot on your computer, now's the time to do it. If not, we can get this to you in other ways. Also want to put this back up here in case folks didn't have a chance to grab it. You can keep putting these things up all day. It doesn't need to be within the pick-me-up. So if you want to screenshot this, think about this later on, how you can engage in your health to better education. What are the changes that you can make in me that will make a more powerful we? Take a screenshot, upload it to social media later on today. Let's come together as a community in healthy ways. All right, let's talk about what we have coming up today. At 11:45, your second day of advisory. If you're in advisory, we got a lot of questions from folks yesterday. Who is my advisor? I will tell you that if you didn't sign up by a certain date, we weren't allowed to sign advisors to everyone. So if you feel like, I don't think I have an advisor, that may be true, but you may have an advisor. And if you want to double check that, please email events@bigpicturelearning. Oh man, you know, we're talking about Big Picture Living this morning. I'm getting confused, but if you want to email events@bigpicturelearning.org. All right, today at 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 Pacific, we kick off our afternoon long Leaving to Learn session. And I want to invite Andrea Purcell on very quickly to kind of give us some context for that. Andrea.
Hello, hello, hello from Los Angeles. And I have seen that we have a fantastic group of about 175 people here this morning on this Zoom. I see people from Belize, from Belfast. I see you, Monette, in Alabama from my advisory, people here on the West Coast and the East Coast and all everywhere in between. If you want, please drop where you are at in the chat so we can start seeing where people are coming at us from. Because the idea this afternoon is that we get off our screen. Hey, Louisville, I see you. The idea this afternoon is that we get off our screen and into our communities, and that we are paying attention to the lessons that can be had in our communities and having these experiences for Leaving to Learn. If you are in an advisory, your advisor will guide you in the setup and prep for your Leave to Learn this afternoon. So if you don't know what to do, go to advisory. Whether you are in advisory or not, you are welcome to come to the session at 1 Eastern to help get yourself situated and know what to do. I'll guide you through some steps that will help you know where to go, what to do, how to report where you are so that you can be part of our collective conversation. But the idea is not for us to be on Zoom for very long at that time. So come if you want to just be part of that conversation, if you need more guidance and where to go, if you already know where you're going, get out. You don't need to come and check in with us. Just go do your thing, document it, because we want to see where you've all been. I know that you will be getting an email if you haven't already that's got a QR code in it. That's a way that one way that you can document and report back where you are at so that we can create a global map of all of the fantastic places people are going. So the goal, get out this afternoon. If you don't know what to do, go to advisory. If you still don't know what to do, come meet with me at 1 o'clock and I'll help you get set up.
Thank you, Andrea. This is my slide. I will admit to my error. The BPL team building session is not at 2:15 Eastern, it's at 5:15 Eastern, but 2:15 Pacific. So you could argue that this is accurate. But Son, you want to talk a little bit about this evening's team building activity?
For sure, family. It goes without saying that culture is super important to any community. And we're trying to encourage folks, if you are within proximity to your squad, your school squad, please get together with them and do something fun and continue to build the culture within your own community. But if not, my partner in justice, Carla, is going to be with me. We're leading a team building activity for about an hour, and we got some really, really fun stuff. So come check us out. It's going to be great.
Son, keep that mic. Tell us about tomorrow's pick me up.
Oh, come on now. You know, a lot of things happen, you know, during this pandemic. So when everything was shut down, our young people just like, nah. And our schools are like, nah, we still gonna do our dang thing. So we are gonna highlight one innovation coming out of Latitude High School out in California, where the entire community came and created an initiative called Run This Town. So we're gonna hear about their story a little bit during the pandemic, but also hopefully inspire us to walk, run, or bike for 10 minutes, y'all, 10 minutes. So bring your running shoes to the pick me up tomorrow, your walking shoes, whatever you're comfortable in. But yeah, that's our pick me up tomorrow, y'all.
Nice. And then tomorrow afternoon, we have 3 breakout session slots. I won't go through the individual sessions. You can find those on the website. I do want to point out one though, because Elliot Washer is doing one-on-ones tomorrow during the 2:15 session, and there are still some slots available. So if you'd like to grab one of those slots to have a one-on-one with the Godfather, Anna's going to drop a link to a form. That is first come, first serve. So go to that form, grab your slot with Elliot, get your one-on-one with BPL co-founder Elliot Washer.
Word up.
I had that slide twice. I'm going to do this all week. So every morning you're going to hear me say, please come to our keynote session with Sonia Renee Taylor. We are very excited to have her with us. I believe she's really excited to be here as well. Though, much like Alicia, she is coming from the other side of the world. She'll be in New Zealand, bright and early for them. We're really excited for that conversation. That will be followed by the encore session. I'd like to keep the elements of the encore session a secret, but I will tell you, you should definitely show up for that, as well as for our closing celebration that evening. That's all Thursday. Okay. I want to tell you that as part of my job, I basically scour Big Picture social media all day long. And among other reasons is because if I just pay attention to sort of the ethosphere, these awesome stories of students just sort of cross my path. So this morning, I discovered a YouTube video of a young man named Joseph Mensah from Vermont. This is a young man pursuing his passion of aviation. And honestly, if you were at yesterday's Pick Me Up, you might be saying, we get it, Vermont, what's going on with Vermont? Why are so many students from Vermont being profiled? I'll tell you why. Our colleague, Beth White, is so committed to the students that she works with and raising them up. We get to learn so much about them and the amazing things they are doing. You may know that Beth herself is passionate about flying, and that just seeps into the young people that she works with. I don't know that Beth is on this morning, but if you get a chance, please wish Beth a happy birthday, because today is her birthday and she is doing incredible things out in the world. I bet that's what she's doing today. All right. That's it for me. Son, before we go, I think Rose is here today. Can you lead us in to the next phase?
Yes, 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 y'all. So as we can imagine, a little technical difficulties yesterday, but it's all love, always love. Typically before we start, our conferences, we want to pay homage, respects, and do a grounds blessing. So we are super, super fortunate today to have Miss Rose Hammack come in and help us lead this blessing a little bit. Rose, you want to grab the microphone and walk us through this?
Good morning, everyone. Before I do this blessing, I just want to introduce myself in our traditional way. So Chinta'e, how are you? Chinta'e is a little bit of our language, Eastern Pomo dialect. And here in Sonoma County, in Santa Rosa, where I live, this is Southern Pomo, Coast Miwok and Wapo territory. And our Pomo people stretch amongst 3 counties here in Northern California, Sonoma Lake and Mendocino County. And a lot of our people are still keeping our language alive, and I've had the honor to bring a little bit of my language and my culture to the kids that we have down in our area. And so the way that I open with our kids in person is burning medicine and doing a prayer with them and just kind of breaking that down. You know, prayer doesn't have to be in language. It doesn't have to be something fancy. You know, just like anything else we do with our youth, it's something that comes from the heart. It's not something we write down. It's not something that is scripted. It's always going to change. but it's always done with good intentions. And the reason I bring this part in to something big like this is often, you know, we don't really get a platform to share who we are, to share our culture. And so it's a blessing anytime we get the opportunity to share that part of ourselves, being a person who does go to ceremony, who does sing, who does dance, basket weaving, beadwork. You know, these are parts of my culture that are very important to me. And so it's just as important that I'm able to pass that on to our students, whether they be native or non-native. It's all about showing love and respect for another person's culture and way of life. And that's how it is in the real world. You know, if we're more understanding and more open to one another, we can live in a good way with one another. You know, instead of just being teachers and students, you know, our students are like our kids. You know, they're an extension of who we are. And, you know, I had mentioned in a small part yesterday that a lot of the times we say our youth are our future leaders, but the youth are our leaders right now. And so anytime that we can support them and give them the tools that keeps them strong, keeps them going, that's what we're gonna do. And so over the pandemic, through COVID, every morning we opened with burning medicine and doing a prayer. And so I just wanted to share that with you all this morning. And I hope it kind of sets high expectations for the rest of your day. And hopefully just gives you leaving here in a good way. And a lot of the time I use that term in a good way. It's just being happy, being uplifted. If you have anything that's heavy on your shoulders, heavy on your heart, you're stressed, you got family stuff going on, this is what this is for. And so I just want to burn some medicine. I know you guys can't smell it and you can't really smudge yourself, you know, bring the medicine to you, but it's just as powerful. And so just like what I did yesterday, and I'm burning white sage. This is medicine that comes from my grandmother's people up in Oregon. But a lot of our Southern California native relatives also burn the white sage. And for our Pomo people, we have medicine called Angelica Root and Mugwort that we will also burn when we're with our students in person. And so, you know, while I burn this medicine, just like yesterday, if you have prayers that need to be said for you and your family, you know, someone who's sick or maybe struggling, please feel free to put their names there in the chat. You know, we want to uplift all of our people. We come from all different areas, all different communities, and you know, prayer is very powerful. And you know, in our way, when we burn our medicine and we have a fire, all those prayers we say for the people that need them, we believe that this smoke, you know, that comes through the fire, it gets carried in the air. And for us, we have different words that we say for God. So sometimes we might say creator, grandfather, God. And some of our Pomo languages, we say Yaki'apin or Yaki'apere. And so, you know, those are some words you may hear me say in my prayer. And please continue. I see a lot of names coming in. So please continue to put your people here in the circle. And again, you know, the way I pray, I close my eyes and I do my prayer. So whatever feels right to you. And if you don't pray, you know, whatever feels right, you know, maybe you want to close your eyes and meditate. Maybe you want to drink some water. Maybe you just want to maybe turn your light off. Whatever is going to help you have that calming, grounding space for yourself. All you relatives out there, the teachers, the young people, everybody. So I'm gonna start my prayer here. Yahweh Yaki'apin, we thank you, Creator, for allowing us to gather in this virtual space. We want to give thanks, Creator, for allowing us to gather here in a good way with good intention to not only uplift one another, but to uplift our young people. We ask you, Creator, in a humble way that you help guide us in a good way. Help us be open-minded and open-hearted and allow us to set certain things aside in ourselves to be the best person we can be, Creator. We also ask you in a humble way to help us guide our young people. And I ask you, Creator, to help our young people, guide them and give them strength. Make sure they remember to be resilient. Make sure that they know their strengths and make sure that they know that they always have people here around them to support them and to push them in a good way. I also ask you, Creator, for all of the people here in this space from all our different areas, that you protect us and watch over us. Can you help us walk in a good way in our lives? It's hard to be educators at times, Creator, so we ask that you help us with peace of mind. You help guide us and you help walk with us. I also ask that all of the people here in this call, that we can continue to have a fun and safe space here, virtual and in person, and just prayer for our world right now, Creator. Prayers for the water, the earth, the moon, the stars, the wind, our animal relatives, our plant relatives. We just give thanks to you, Creator, for allowing us to have the space to be with one another. And we have gratitude for you for giving us the best gift, and that's the gift of waking up this morning, for us to have this breath of life to continue to do good things in our path. And we thank you for giving us each other, for having support for one another, and having a safe space to be together as we continue to deal with what our world is going through right now. We say thank you, Creator Yahweh. Oh. Thank you, everyone, for allowing me to share that with you all.
Thank you, Rose.
Rose, thank you so much for that. Blessings to you for making time for us. Everyone, let's have an incredible day. Just gonna check out with some music. And just wanna thank everybody for being here today. So let's have a wonderful day, y'all. Love yourself, love your community. Let's love each other and let's have a great day, y'all.